The Xperia Z Ultra represents a new breed of device. It can take photos and shoot HD video underwater, has a superb screen that works with a bog-standard pencil, and is the world's most powerful smartphone. It also probably hasn't gone unnoticed that this thing is huge, but this is more than just a giant 6.4-inch waterproof smartphone that looks good. It's the slimmest large-screened handset out there at 6.5mm thick, and the result is something that feels solid and quite comfortable in the hand, thanks to its quality aluminium tempered glass body and that skinny physique. Now, like its Xperia Z siblings, it's waterproof but submerged to a deeper limit of 1.5 meters for half an hour. The Z Ultra takes it one step further by being able to take snap and shoot video underwater. Even more impressive is the flap-free headphone jack. Now, its 1080p screen is looking impressive. Icons, pictures and movies look crisp, clear and bright with vividly natural colours, which could be down to Sony's triluminous Bravia screen tech and X-Reality engine. And how's this for a bit of techno witchcraft? Check out the screen's ability to work with regular pencils and a selection of pens instead of a stylus. Now, we're yet to put it through its paces, but it's the fastest phone in the world, so we've got pretty high hopes. It handled this HD movie trailer without tripping up, thanks to Qualcomm's quad-core processor, which runs along at a very speedy 2.2 gigahertz. Now, an 8-megapixel camera sits around the back, complete with Sony's intelligent auto feature, with photos appearing decent on screen. Now, this will definitely be a two-handed phone for most of you, and if you're concerned about using such a big device, you can bag the optional smart Bluetooth handset, which connects via NFC for calls, viewing text messages, or listening to music. Or you could run the risk of looking like this. The Xperia Z Ultra has clearly got Samsung's supersized devices in its sights, and while it might not be able to fit in your skinny jeans, it looks set to be a killer device. And it certainly feels like a phone, perhaps due to its insanely thin body and gorgeous design, but make no mistake, it is a phablet. As ever, look out for a full review on Stuff.tv very soon.